stroke. And the same hospital that my mom passed at, we were back at that same hospital in her memorial. The doctors and everybody remembered us because it's a family of 10, plus all of our in-laws. But I want you to know, he hasn't been able to walk in 4.5 years. And the other day, my husband said, Rhonda, I went in that room and Keith was in his wheelchair. Now I know the night before, I didn't put him in the bed because I was sleeping in a deep coma. And so every morning I get up and I go to the gym, and then I leave the gym. I go in a room to put him in his wheelchair so I can get him his food. Well, I went back in the room. And Phyllis, he said to me, he said, I just need you to, because he talked a lot of noise. He has very good sense. There's nothing wrong with him. He said, I just need you to stand by that mirror so I won't fall and bust it. I said, what are you going to do? He said, I'm going to put myself in this wheelchair. I'm talking about what faith will do. Y'all playing in here. But I stood by the wheelchair and he scooted himself on the side of the bed and he was scooting. And I'm watching him because I know what I've been praying. And I've been praying, God, you're going to have to do this thing because it's a hard task trying to take care of a brother that's used to doing stuff on his own. And I ain't got to go off into when one family member's sick, it's only one person that's going to take care of him. I ain't going into that for somebody else in my situation. So he scooted himself over Carnel and he kept scooting over and he raised and put the